Good evening. As we go to air tonight, a major manhunt is underway across Adelaide for a prisoner who broke out of the Adelaide Remand Centre.
Jason Burden escaping through a vent at the maximum security facility. The fugitive then accused of committing more crimes as he tries to avoid capture.
This security vision shows just how easy it was for fugitive Jason Burden to escape. He emerges from an air vent high on one side of the remand centre, then lowers himself onto the footpath before casually walking down Phillip Street through the city. Left hanging, a string of clothes tied together, dangling from the broken vent around 10 metres off the ground. But by the time authorities realised he'd escaped the remand centre, the only remaining trace of him, two dusty footprints on the footpath.
You see what's here? I'll probably describe it as brazen. We are now making numerous inquiries to locate Jason Burden, and we'd ask the members of the public, if they see him, to not approach him, but to call police.
Burden was in the kitchen area of the maximum security prison when he broke out just before 10 a.m. Vision shows the panic as guards looked for him in front of amazed witnesses. Police swarming the scene almost half an hour later, but the wanted prisoner was long gone. Investigators quickly realising he'd stolen an electric bike on North Terrace and was fleeing west.
There's an extensive CCTV camera network throughout the CBD, and we've been able to monitor and track his movements to Port Road.
More than 2 hours later, and at least 15 kilometres away, that bike was found when an aquatics instructor at West Lakes reported her car had been stolen. The vehicle, a black Toyota RAV4 with distinct roof racks and awning.
Somebody came into our staff area and stole some gear from some of our instructors while they were out on the water. Phones, wallets, backpack, car keys, and then a car.
Police say Burden was on remand, charged with firearms offences and breaching bail.
Some firearms offences at the lower end. We would like to apprehend him as soon as possible, but currently we believe he doesn't pose a risk to the community.
The kitchen clothing used to drop to the ground seized as evidence, with an investigation tonight underway into how this was able to happen.
There have been no other confirmed sightings of Burden since he was last seen here at the West Lakes Rowing Club. The police helicopter has been up this afternoon scouring this area as well as out towards Largs Bay. But the message is, if you do see him, do not approach him. Instead, immediately call police, who are obviously very keen to find Burden tonight and get him back into custody. Brenton.
Kate Lamb, thank you. And with the search still underway, the political fallout from this jailbreak has already begun. Harvey Biggs is at the Adelaide Remand Centre. Harvey, the state government is under fire for privatising the prison last year.
They are, Brenton, and it's coming from the opposition and Prison Guards Union, who are connecting the dots from when the keys were handed to private company Serco just over a year ago. They say since then staffing levels have dropped and now have had the first prison break in more than 20 years. You might remember when privatisation plans were first announced, prison guards actually took to the streets, fearing that jobs would be lost and their work environment would become more dangerous. The state government at the time said safety would not be compromised and it would save millions of dollars by doing this. But now there are calls for the contract with Serco to be torn up and management to return back to public hands.
From the get-go, what has happened is that Serco have slashed the staffing numbers by half. This is clearly not going to be conducive to a safe environment within a prison.
This privatisation was done in order to save $8 million a year. Now, is $8 million a year worth the escape of dangerous criminals into the CBD?
This time the priority, and I think the priority you would agree, sir, is for SAPOL to apprehend this offender and place him back into custody. That's what the priority is, sir, not playing petty political games.
Minister Tarzio also says the PSA's claims on staffing levels are inappropriate and reckless and only put staff in danger. Neither Serco nor the Corrections Department would face the cameras today. Kate?
Harvey, thank you.